I am Eduardo Solis, and you are listening to Con Talk, episode number 95, Alamo City Furry Invasion 2021. There is an old saying that best describes conventions this year as they do their best to get back into the swing of things. You play with the cards you're dealt. In going with the Mad Max-inspired theme of fire and furry, the road to Furry Invasion 2021 and the con itself was a bit of a bumpy ride. After a pretty good 2019 event at the Wyndham San Antonio Riverwalk, their 2020 con was canceled just like pretty much everything else last year. Unfortunately for Furry Invasion, the Wyndham also shut down, which forced the convention to switch hotels. Furry Invasion 2021 took place at the Marriott Plaza Hotel in downtown San Antonio. Those of you who listened to my last episode, and I know you did, may remember that I stayed in that hotel during San Japan. Furry Invasion happened on October 8th through the 10th, and just like during San Japan, the Texas heat sucked some of the fun out of the weekend. Big Texas Comic-Con also took place over that weekend. Temperatures were in the high 80s and even hit 90 on Sunday, so now I really have to wonder if whoever is in charge of the weather has a problem with nerds. Naturally, as we are still in the throes of the COVID pandemic, the convention took precautions in order to keep everyone safe. Like other events, proof of vaccination or a recent negative COVID test was required to get a badge. Unlike other events, Furry Invasion required attendees to pass a temperature check every day, so good on them for going that extra mile. Wristbands were given after a successful daily test, but as wristbands are really inconvenient for fursuiting, fursuiters ended up sticking them to their lanyards or their badges. And that leads me to this year's registration screw-up. Registration was originally scheduled to be at a building outside of the hotel, but due to a network cable being cut, registration ended up being hastily moved to the hotel proper, which took a few hours. Registration did eventually open, and I was happy to get a decent spot in line. I was less happy when I got to the front, registered, and was told I couldn't get my badge until I passed my temperature check for the day. That meant getting checked, getting the pink wristband for Friday, which I would affectionately refer to as my pink slip, and getting at the end of the now really long registration line. I decided to sit in the lobby with my laptop, wait for the reg line to get shorter, and stew in my own juices. After taking a seat, opening up my laptop, and firing off an angry tweet, my friends Bunner and Wolfboy just happened to enter the lobby and let me know that they were looking for me in registration. Since I now had my pink slip, I bypassed the line and went straight to registration where I was given my badge. Now, but for my friends showing up, I would have probably waited at least a half an hour. So yeah, another year, another fun time in registration. When I said, you play with the cards you're dealt at the top, I was mainly referring to the hotel. Furry Invasion was split up into three areas. There was the main building with the hotel rooms, a smaller building nearby the hotel where main events, a photo booth, and the game room were at, and two historic buildings that were a little bit of a walk away that were used for the dealer's den, the artist's alley, and panel rooms. Thus, a lot of the convention took place outdoors where the Texas heat makes things suck, especially for fursuiters. As is often the case with an older hotel, the elevators were dog slow, but stairs were available. The dealer's den consisted of a few connected rooms in one of the historic buildings, while the artist alley was spread out over a second building. Both dealers and artists were on the ground floor, and there were a good selection of vendors. One thing I noticed was that there seemed to be a lack of panels at this year's Furry Invasion. I was tempted to submit some myself, but I have had issues in the past with panel scheduling and room setup, so I decided to pass. Sure enough, panels were not assigned rooms. Instead, you had to hunt around for the panel that you wanted to attend. That wouldn't have been too big of a deal if the panel rooms hadn't all been on the second floor of the historic buildings. Unfortunately, because they're historic buildings, they did not have elevators. Thus, people that were unable to physically go up the stairs had to miss out. With everything being so spread out and so few things going on, Furry Invasion 2021 felt more like a big fur meet as opposed to an actual convention for me. Honestly though, that ain't bad. I spent the better part of the weekend catching up with friends that I hadn't seen in over a year and a half, took lots of pictures of fursuiters, did some fursuiting myself, and I had a fun weekend. Furry Invasion did the best with what they had, and it ended up being a pretty good show overall. No announcements have been made regarding next year's Furry Invasion. I don't think I'm alone in hoping that they move to a different hotel where everything is inside, or maybe push the date forward another week or two in the hope that the weather is a little more cooperative. Overall, Furry Invasion 2021 went fairly well, and I consider it to be a good convention. That said, the consistent issues that I have experienced over the years with registration and panels keep me from calling it a great one. For more information, visit furryinvasion.com. And now, some other events. The 4th annual MexAmeriCon is happening November the 13th in Austin at the Emma S. Barrientos Mexican American Cultural Center. The event will be held outdoors at the Zocalo from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. MexAmeriCon will feature Mexican American and Latino artists who work through the medium of comic books, graphic novels, zines, and other media. There will be an artist alley as well as interviews and panels exploring topics relating to comics and Latino culture. For more information, visit MexAmeriCon.com. After missing their usual 2020 and 2021 dates, San Antonio's MiniMinCon will be holding their next event on December the 4th at the Wonderland of the Americas Mall. The event will be called MiniMinCon Lite and is going to feature dealers, artists, a cosplay show, an indie gaming showcase, and performances. Performer submissions are going to be taken until November the 15th, and indie gaming showcase signups are happening until November the 20th. Personally, I would have gone with MiniMinCon for the name, but that's just me. For more information, visit MiniMinCon.com. And that'll do it for episode number 95 of Con Talk. Click like, hit subscribe, and maybe I'll see you at a con sometime. I am Eduardo Solis, and I thank you for listening. Be good, take care, and God bless.